Very good morning to you all. Now, and congratulations, Dr. Rohit, for putting up this conference. Now, I'm a pharmacologist among all of you, predominantly cardiologists and cardiac surgeons. So I may go overboard at some times, so do bear with me. Now, recently, Dr. Neeraj, he concluded with the presentation on novel oral anticoagulants. Now, in case of patient who is on novel oral anticoagulants, they bleed, they start bleeding. Now, for warfarin, we have an antidote which is vitamin K is normally used. For the novel oral anticoagulants, what we use is either we withdraw the oral anticoagulants for a few days, or we go for mechanical or surgical approaches. FFP may be given, activated charcoal may be given if it has been taken recently, within few hours. Or recombinant factor 8, A also has been given in some cases. Then hemodialysis is used for dabigatran only. Now these are mainly used for mild to moderate cases of bleeding. But what in case of severe bleeding? Now, in severe cases, there is no antidote which was available some time back. But recently, specific reversal agent dabigatran has been introduced. Edarucizumab, which is a reversal agent for dabigatran. Now, this has been introduced recently. And prothrombin complex concentrates, they are given in cases. Earlier they were followed, but there are also chances of thrombosis because of that. Now, edarucizumab, which is available by the trade name of Traxbind. Now, this is a specific reversal agent for dabigatran. It is a fully humanized monoclonal antibody fragment, which has been approved by FDA in October 2015. So, it is approved for reversal of anticoagulant effect of dabigatran in case of emergency surgery or urgent invasive procedures or in case of life-threatening or uncontrolled bleeding. Now, this binds specifically to dabigatran, both to the free and the thrombin-bound dabigatran, and inhibits its anticoagulant effect. So it binds over here to factor 2A. Now the binding of dabigatran with thrombin, this is almost 350 times higher of edarucizumab with thrombin is almost 350 times that of dabigatran binding to thrombin. So it is highly bound to thrombin as compared to much better bound binding to thrombin as compared to dabigatran. Now this is structurally quite similar to thrombin and mimics its action, but it does not activate any clotting. No cases of procoagulant or anticoagulant effects have been seen with edarucizumab. It rapidly and completely reverses the anticoagulant effect of dabigatran within minutes, and the effect lasts up to 24 hours. However, it does not reverse any other novel oral anticoagulant, rivaroxaban or any other. Now this is the graph which shows the effect on DTT, diluted thrombentine with edarucizumab. Now after giving edarucizumab, now the level of this DTT, it decreases greatly and it lasts for up to 24 hours as is shown in the lower two lines in the green and yellow. Whereas otherwise, those shown in blue, the upper ones, now the effect tapers off almost after 16 to 24 hours. So it is very, very effective in reducing the effect of dabigatran. Now, edarucizumab, as far as pharmacokinetics is concerned, it has a very short half-life of around 45 minutes. And the coagulation is restored in the person in 24 hours. But it independently does not cause hemostasis. Now, it is administered intravenously and it has immediate onset of action, and it is eliminated renally. However, even in patients who have renal impairment, it does not affect the reversal of anticoagulant effect of dabigatran by edaracuzumab. So it is found to be effective even in patients who are having renal impairment. Now, how it is given? It is given intravenously in a dose of 5 grams. Now, there are two vials available. It is available in a as 2.5 gram per 50 ml vial. Now, you have to give two vials of this, either continuously, as continuous infusion, or as a bolus injection. But this has to be given over a period of 15 minutes. They can be given 5 to 10 minutes apart, but over a period of 15 minutes, that is, they have to be given. Now, they can be given in a pre-existing IV line, but you have to first flush it with normal saline, and then give it, and then flush it again if you are to give some other medication. And you are not to combine any medication with this drug. Now, in a trial, reverse AD clinical trial, which has recently been published in NEJM, it is the reversal effect of edaracuzumab on active dabigatran trial. Now, based on this trial, based on the interim analysis of this trial around 2 years back, the effects were found to be so good that FDA gave accelerated approval to this drug because there were no other similar drugs available. So now this trial, which has recently been completed and published in NEJM on 11th of July 2017. Now, the study validates the finding which were there in the interim analysis. Now, it enrolled 503 patients at 173 sites in 39 countries. Now, they were enrolled into two groups. In group A, the number of patients were 301 who had serious bleeding episodes. And in group B, the patients were 202 patients were included who required urgent surgery. Now, in both the groups, the median maximal percentage reversal was 100%. This was seen in more than 98% of the patients on the basis of the diluted thrombin time or Ekerin clotting time within 4 hours. Now, when the samples were taken 4 and 12 hours after administration of edaracuzumab, the lab test showed normal coagulation levels in almost 90% of the patients, and restoration of hemostasis was achieved in less than 12 hours in more than 98% of the patients. Normal blood clotting homeostasis during surgery was reported in those patients who were in the group B where surgery was performed. So homeostasis was seen in 93.4% of the patients, and mild to moderate homeostasis was seen in rest of the patient. No serious clotting interval changes, clotting time changes were seen in any of the patient. So the median time to bleeding cessation was 2.5 hours in group A, where they were seriously bleeding, maybe because of GI bleeding or intracranial bleeding. In group B, the median time to initiation of the intended procedure, whatever surgery the patient required, it was 1.6 hours. When the patients were analyzed at 3 months, at 90 days, now thrombotic events had occurred in 6.3% of the patients in group A, and in group B in 7.4 patients. But it was seen that these patients, they had not restarted the anticoagulant therapy after being given edaracuzumab. The 90-day mortality rate was similar in both the groups, 18.8% and 18.9%. And these were seen related to the coexisting conditions of the patient. And no serious adverse safety signals were reported. Although 117 patients, in almost 23% of the patients, they had adverse events, but they were mainly attributed to the index event or the coexisting condition. And the most common adverse effects which were seen were, in group A, it was delirium. In group B, it was cardiac arrest in 3.5% and septic shock. But again, on further analysis, it was seen that they were associated with the coexisting condition. Now, it is very important that these patients, after they are given a darolutamide, after the effect is complete, maybe after 24 hours or 48 hours, they are started on anticoagulants again. So appropriate follow-up is very essential in these patients. And there have been no contraindications to the use of these drugs. So overall, based on this trial, it was concluded that edaruxuzumab rapidly, durably, completely, and safely reversed the anticoagulant effect of dabigatran within minutes. So when to restart dabigatran after edaruxuzumab has been given to the patient, we can start it after 24 hours if the patient is found to be clinically stable in all other aspects. And the hemostasis is also there. Now, after this, can we administer another dose of edaruxuzumab? Yes, it can be given if there is potential rebleeding in the patient or if another emergency surgery is required in the patient. Now, it also does not have, in the current clinical trial, it has been found that no immunogenic anti-activity was seen. If it was seen in few patients, it was not significant. And so another dose can be given because no antibodies were formed. Now, based on these studies, now in India, it has been approved. It has been given a accelerated approval in India also based on the phase 3 findings in US because there were no other specific therapy available for this. So DCGI gave accelerated approval to this drug. Now as far as the cost of the drug, it is costly. In US it is around 3500 for the 5-gram dose, in Australia around 2100, and in India it is varies 70,000 to 1 lakh, 1.25 lakh. Now, apart from edaruxuzumab is mainly active against dabigatran, but there are other anticoagulants, rivaroxaban and others. Now, for that, there is no antidote. And rivaroxaban has been found in 2015, around more than 8,000 people died because of the excessive bleeding because of rivaroxaban. And there was no antidote available. And it was the most... it was the side effect which caused most deaths in that year because of any drug. Now, endexanet alpha and seraparantag, these are two newer reversal agents which are under development. Now, endexanet alpha, it is a recombinant factor 10A. For rivaroxaban, edoxaban, and apixaban. So it competes with the native factor 10A to bind to these apixaban, edoxaban, rivaroxaban, and it also binds to heparin and low molecular weight heparins. But it has not recently been approved by FDA, but they have submitted the findings of the trials, and it will be, the findings will be out by early 2018. Seraparantag is effective against heparin, even dabigatran and rivaroxaban, apixaban, and edoxaban. So it is a broad spectrum, but phase 3 trials are still going on. So overall, edaruxuzumab has been found to be a very effective drug as far as the trial was concerned, but further trials are being going on. So it rapidly and completely reversed the anticoagulant effect of dabigatran within minutes, and no serious adverse effects have been seen and no contraindications have been seen. And it is very important that after being given edaruxuzumab, the patient should be followed for whether the patient is taking anticoagulant or not. And even in some cases, dabigatran again was given in patients who were under trial. That's all. Thank you.